We're broadcasting live from Stairway to Heaven Arena in downtown Purgatory. The crowd is going wild and partying like it's 1999.
I think someone opened Pandora's box and all hell broke loose.
It's the Mayhem Bowl, and today's matchup features the two best teams in the league. The Blitzburgh Steelheads battle the Cardinal Sins. For tonight's presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. We are going down to the sidelines now to listen in on the pregame speech. Kickoff to the biggest game of the year. The MFL Mayhem Bowl is just moments away. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here, along with color commentator Brickhead Mulligan and the mini Pez dispenser on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
Grim, I can't wait for the Mayhem Bowl start. I got a lot of money riding on it.
Pez dispenser, huh? Yeah, better than having that crap dispenser pie hole you got for a mouth.
And moving on. And it's first and ten.
At least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. Oh, I love this dirty trick. T5 ball fun. Stomp him into the ground. And nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10.
Sound of bones snapping and cracking. I mean, when they're not yowling.
And it's first and 10. Throw it and catch it too. Third down, and the punter is warming up. When the defense calls thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, you ever heard that Zappa song, "Watch Out Where the Huskies Go"? Don't you eat that yellow snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones.
Touchdown saving tackle right there. First down and one.
One, a two, a three.
Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. The extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, but see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. Maybe he passes it for maybe a yard. They've got to open up the offense here, Bricks. Third down and nine. First quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
Third down, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down in a mile. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grin.
Third down and never gonna happen. Six-yard game. They quickly call a timeout, hoping to save some time for their offense. There's no reason to go for it here, but they do anyway. And they can hit the 13 feet with dirty trick, and there's no way to stop. Devastating hit knocks the ball loose. Point.
And a well-placed...
And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. Man, this coach must have played... And the offense jumps on sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Position in football, the mighty punter. Nice punt, should move him back nicely. And that'll be a touchback.
I don't feel comfortable giving a massage while I'm broadcasting, Ben.
And it's first and 10. Three on that play. one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
Second down and 7. First and 10. And that pass play is good for 8 yards. Second down and 2. He's running out of gas now. He's up, and he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had somehow today. Looks like it's a good fit.
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. We're at the Mayhem Bowl, and the third quarter is about to start. Neither team really pulling away.
What's about who wants it more, Grim? And who's going to run into a saw blade by accident? And who's going to be the unlucky bastard that steps on the line? And who?
Yeah, we get the idea. And why don't you be the unlucky bastard that falls down the stairs on your way to get your hot dog?
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Second down and 4.
Hot 1, hot 2,
hot 3. The bomb goes off, hurting no one.
Yeah, the bomb don't kill anyone. Does it still make a sound?
Third and 4.
So hard. I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow. You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
That's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. Quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Second down and a lot. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. Second down and 10. Looks like the defense called a ginormous dirty. Wow! The quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. First down and 1. Says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. Stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. And that is a big gain. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Third and 4. And the offense quickly calls their second time out. That's how you do it. Wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, saving Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sense. I took it as a compliment.
Too little, too late, and they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Glenn.
Well, and the defense, too. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Anticipated a pass there and put an end to their offensive drive. Like my wife always said, not tonight. And it's first and 10. First and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
The defender's one feet just kicked in.
He's so bad.
Second down and more than the QB would like.
Hot two.
The defense better look out. The offense called the beast boot dirty trick. Sinful loss in a game that certainly didn't live up to the hype but was entertaining. If you like lopsided wins, we're crowning a new Mayhem Bowl champion today.
I had a lopsided girlfriend once. She was a strange one.
Well, it was with you. That kind of says it all, right?
On to the Mayhem Bowl MVP. Once again, the folks at Evil Sam thank our viewing audience and the Newton Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. Until next season, this is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off. And that's a wrap. All right, that's another season, boys. Good job. Hey, Bricks, let the cheerleaders in, huh? Hey, Junior, start rolling.
On it, boss.
I love you guys. We got the best gig in the world.
Hey, stow it, dipshit. Start filling the hot tub. Hey, where's the champagne?
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so...